secret? Then come on in to Disney's House of Mouse.
Who's that knocking at the House of Mouse? We're all knocking at the House of Mouse. So come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're all rocking at the House of Mouse. We're having a ball and rocking the hall. So come on in,
to the House of Mouse.
Makes you jump and shout. Hey, little girl, I wanna dance with you. We'll find so many things to do. So come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're having a ball
at the House of Mouse.
And now, the most mouse for your money, Mickey Mouse.
Hiya, folks. Say, I heard the seven dwarves were late getting here tonight. Seems they locked their keys in their van and took a whole hour to get Dopey out. And now for the latest scoop on what the toons are up to, here's some Main Street gossip.
Main Street gossip, yeah!
Clarabelle Cow here, tattling the tales of Toontown. And I've got some juicy dish today. First off, ears are wagging about the pairing of two of Toondom's biggest cheeses. Sources reveal Mickey and Minnie Mouse are dating.
Well, everybody already knows that.
Next, a certain foul-tempered fowl gets angry at the first ruffled feather. Yes, Donald Duck has an awful temper.
What? I've never been mad.
Where has she been?
Well, how about this? Word has it, a certain Dippy Dog has been labeled an incurable klutz. Goofy is clumsy with a capital C.
Gorsh, I hadn't heard that.
Can it. Your news is older than Rafiki.
Older than Rafiki.
I have other big news.
What, that Snow White's the fairest of them all?
Ouch. I didn't want to do this, but I guess I have no choice. I hold in my hand the biggest secret this town has never heard. It involves a certain someone, a certain somewhere, and a certain something. But I'm not going to tell you until the end of the show.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, what's Clarabelle's secret? Do tell all.
You seek an answer, and an answer I see. And all I'll reveal is it's not about me.
Here's a secret I'll share with you. This top secret cartoon.
Hit it, Horace.
You there, ironing your underwear. Or cooking, or washing your dishes. Do you ever feel like someone's watching you?
I sure hope not.
What about your neighbor across the street? Did you ever think they could be out to get you?
What should I do?
You have to get them before they get you. Order the Ajax Secret Spy Kit. That's right. You too can be a spy.
Send me a spy kit on the double. My top secret spy kit!
Hello, paranoid citizen. I am designed to teach you all you need to know to be a spy. Now, place me just behind your ear.
Can you hear me?
Loud and clear. Loud.
Before we begin, you must put on your spy suit. It should fit snug.
Snug.
Lesson one, self-defense. In your front pocket, find what looks like a pen. Now that you've mastered the laser pen, you're ready for lesson two, debugging.
Bugs in my phone! Bugs in my phone!
Dumb joke.
Bugs in my phone! Bugs in my phone!
Lesson three, infiltration. Infiltration complete. Now, open your secret spy briefcase.
Whoops! Forgot it.
Lesson four, sneaking around. A spy must sneak about without making so much as a peep. Excellent. No one will ever suspect you're here. Lesson five, cracking locks. Get out the secret spy door opener.
Credit card.
Carefully slide the credit card in the crack of the door.
$75?
Lesson six, camouflage. Quickly, press the automatic disguise feature on your secret spy wristband.
Gosh, someone is after me. They're plumb. Goofy! Oh, my gosh! Now they're sneaking up on me!
Lesson seven, self-defense. In the event someone's sneaking up on you, remove the knockout gas umbrella from your left thigh pocket. I said your left pocket! Open the umbrella to release a stunning cloud of knockout gas.
Your man, wait until he's opened that ridiculous umbrella and gassed himself. Then position yourself at the bottom of the stairs and wait patiently. Good work. And that concludes your Ajax Catch a Man course.
Clarabelle? I need to talk to you. You know that that big secret you're gonna tell? Well, it's about me, isn't it?
About you?
I knew it. Look, I just want my ears to look nice and round from every angle. So that's why I have them starched every week.
Really?
Oh, Clarabelle, I know the big secret is about me, but I can explain.
You can?
You must have seen me at the movies with Mortimer.
I did.
But it was so not a date. I just had to get Mortimer out of Mickey's hair so Mickey could plan the show. You'd never understand, but you understand, right?
Well, you are part goose?
See for yourself.
Duck, duck, goose. Actually, you're more goose than duck. Your name should be Donald Goose.
Don't tell anybody. I'll be ruined.
It's safe to talk here. Now, my secret's not about Mickey's ears or Donald being a goose.
Wait, you know about all that?
Sure. I may be goofy, but I ain't dumb. But the real secret is...
Yes?
That I really am clumsy. Wait! I can prove it! It's true. I've actually met a couple of people who can hunt like Gaston.
I'm not really late, and I don't have a date. I'm a frog.
I'm afraid of the dark. There. I said it.
Oh, oh.
I don't think I can print that. Oh, what a day, what a day. Just you two wait till you hear the big secret.
Oh, yeah, I can hardly wait.
Don't forget, peoples, coming up soon, I'll be revealing the biggest secret in the world. So don't go away.
Don't worry, Clarabelle. Nobody wants to miss that. Just like you don't want to miss this next cartoon.
Valentine's Day. I wonder if Donald's got anything special planned.
Happy Valentine's Day, Brooks.
My goodness, you've certainly been shot by Cupid's arrow. Is this for me? Thank you. This coupon entitles Miss Daisy Duck to order Mr. Donald Duck to do anything she would like on Valentine's Day. You? You're my present?
Yep! I'm the one!
Oh, Donald, you'll do anything I want?
Anything!
I know what I want. I want you to build me a brick wall.
What?
Yes, a big brick fence for privacy. My nosy neighbor Clara Cluck always catches me when I look in her windows. She's such a snoop.
You're hot, Gamma.
Nah, you can build me one of those next year. Today, I want a brick fence.
But...
Donald, you said anything.
I'm sorry.
We now return to the vain and the whiny.
Why, Jillian, what's the matter? Oh, Orchid, I'm all alone on Valentine's Day. Jillian, Jillian, why sit at home crying? You need to get out and find yourself a big, strong man.
I'm bringing it like bread. I don't know what's done for me.
Why, what about Dimitri? You know, he's just so strong. And so handsome.
Why, yes, I think you're right. He is graceful. Even-tempered. Nothing ever seems to bother him. Why, he just might be... the perfect man.
Hey, what's the big idea? Beat it, I'm busy.
Here.
being a peeping Don?
What a dude! I can explain.
Go ahead.
Well, when he just popped out, and I looked in and over it.
To win a man.
Donald, cherish him and keep your hands off his bricks. Well, then, I now pronounce you.
Wait! Oh, Donald, I drove you away by forcing you to work on that awful fence. No wonder you turned to someone else.
That's what happened.
Oh, I'll do anything to make it up to you.
Anything?
Anything.
It's the best Valentine's Day, huh, Toots?
Yeah, great.
Oh, Daisy!
Yeah?
I got a refill, please.
Hey, Minnie, I saw you talking to Clarabelle earlier, and, you didn't mention, did you?
Oh, no! I wouldn't mention your ears any more than I would mention me going to the movies with Mortimer. Oops!
Come on, spill that secret, you pompous bathroom accessory.
Whew! That ought to stop Clarabelle from telling my secret.
Hello, Minnie. I am off to tell the big secret.
Don't let me stop you.
Hey, Clarabelle! The stud's here to see ya.
Horace Horse Collar!
That'll stop her from tattling my tail.
Oh, that's my cue. I'm on.
And now, Toondom's biggest blabbermouth is back to reveal the big secret.
Ooh, a secret so big and so secret that someone will never work in this town again. The big secret is, the big secret is that I am quitting Main Street Rumors.
Didn't see that coming.
Yes, that's right. There just aren't any good secrets anymore. Not a single one anywhere. And so, the someone who will never work in this town again is me.
But we liked hearing all your silly rumors.
Oh, good! Because now I have so much new gossip, I've decided to write a tell-all book! Oh!
Thanks for being here, folks. Sorry the gossip was lousy, but sometimes no news is good news. Right, Clarabelle?
Right, Mickey. Say, your ears sure look starchy. I mean, nice and round.
Yeah. Say, Mike, why don't you take us out of here, huh?
Non-stop gossip for the House of Mouse, provided by Clarabelle Cow's Tales of the Tunes. 1,001 tasty tidbits to talk about. Discover Mickey Mouse's fixation with keeping his ears perfectly round. What is Minnie Mouse doing at the movies with Mortimer? And read about the famous Donald Duck, who might just be more goose than mallard. Get all the tasty dish with Clarabelle Cow's Tales of the Tunes. Secret subject to baseless rumor.
See y'all real soon. And remember, mum's the word.
Hey, everybody, it's me, Goofy. And did you know that some snails can sleep for 3 to 4 years? Gosh, that's a really long nap. They sure must be tired. But I guess I'd be tired, too, if it took me 2 weeks to walk down my driveway. So next time you see a snail, give him a lift. I'm sure he'd appreciate it. I'll talk to you later.